Good afternoon to all. I do not have the formal presentation on this, but I will throw the views regarding the energy storage as far as the Indian power system is concerned. So I will take around five to seven minutes.
No, you have 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
And I will warn you when you reach the end, just to so that you know where you stand.
Okay. Thanks. Thank you. So if you see the Indian power system, so presently we have around 369 gigawatt is the installed capacity, out of which 22% is contribution through the renewable energy sources. In terms of the mainly the wind, around 37 gigawatt, and solar is around 32, balance is the biomass and small hydro. And this 86 gigawatt of renewable is contributing the total energy need is around 9 to 10% of that. So this is the present scenario. Now we have very ambitious plan. Our government has a very ambitious plan to keep this capacity around 175 gigawatt by 2022 and around 240 gigawatt by 2025. So that means this capacity of 22% has to be around 39 to 40%. And the total energy portfolio, as far as the electricity is concerned, that 66% presently is contribution through the thermal sector. So that will reduce to around 50% by 2025. And hydro is also contributing, presently is around 13%. That will again brought down to around 9 to 10%. So more focus is on renewable energy. Basically, the objective is to provide 24/7 clean, low-cost power made available to every consumer, be it the domestic consumers, be it industrial, commercial business, agriculture, public utilities, etc. So that's the basic thing, and enhance the per capita consumption of electricity too. So presently we have around 1,200 kilowatt hour, and that has to be increased to around 1,600 plus kilowatt hour by 2025. That's the target as far as the Indian power sector is concerned. So we are basically driven by this clean energy, and that too also not only in the electricity sector, also in the transport sector. This kind of renewable energy uses is going to happen. So now what is happening, because the more and more solar energy is integrating into the grid, and that solar is mainly available only during the daytime. So after the sunset, we will again depends upon the conventional or hydro, this wind energy, wherever that quality of the wind is available after the sunset. So here is the thing, is since we will again depend upon the conventional during the evening time or night time, so what we will do with that conventional during the daytime when there is lot of energy coming from the solar? So presently the conventional generations are getting backing down, so their plant load factor is keep on reducing. Though we have the regulation is already in place, so the thermal plant, the coal-fired plant, can operate so 55% of its capacity. So that regulation is already in place. So that means this PLF is reducing. So there are a lot of issues coming up. So here the storage will play a dominant role to not only store this energy which is coming from the nature in terms of the solar and wind, also to enhance the PLF of the conventional generation. So we can store it during the daytime, and during the evening time or night time we can discharge that. And more so important because of the electric vehicle penetration. So that will also play a prominent role. Now what kind of storage? So I am not coming into that because lot of deliberation already held. But anyhow, storage is required. We already have the pump storage hydro, around 4,500 megawatt is already commissioned, but presently around, out of that, around 50% plus is under operation. The some plants with little bit modification can be made operational, and we have the total potential of the pump storage hydro is around 96 gigawatt in the country. So lot of emphasis is being given so that the pump storage hydro can be developed. We also have the power market, because since the renewables are characterized by three factors. One, we say that it is intermittent and uncertain. The output from this kind of generation is highly intermittent and uncertain. Then also the output is variable too. Even if it is available, it is a variable. It depends upon the nature. If it is a wind, depends upon the wind speed, depends upon the wind direction, depends upon the ambient temperature. Similarly for the solar, depends upon the radiation, whether it is a global, whether it is a direct, everything. So it is a variable too. The another important factor is that since we are going ahead with the large scale renewables, like ultra mega solar power park, the capacity of each park is around say 2000 megawatt. So at one location, the capacity is 2000 megawatt. 4,000 megawatt, minimum 500 megawatt. So it is a big type of things. And these kind of generations are having the short gestation period in comparison to development of the transmission infrastructure to get these renewable energy source connected to the national grid. The transmission will take a lot of time. It is a linear project. There are many issues like rights of way, land acquisition for establishment of new substation. Whereas this kind of generation can be established, say 12 months, 18 months, 20 months, like that. So there may be a mismatch. So what we did in this direction, to avoid the mismatch of this, we have planned the transmission infrastructure based upon the renewable energy potential zone. Is though everywhere sunlight is there, wind is blowing, but the quality of wind, quality of the radiation level is not equal or uniform across the country. So we identify that they are the potential solar and wind energy zone, that is the renewable energy zone, and this is the potential which can be developable in the next 5 years' time, in the next 6 years' time. So based upon that potential and the demand projection, where the power has to go, we have the renewable purchase obligation in line with the regulation. So that is in place. So based upon that, we evolve, conceptualize, and plan the transmission infrastructure required to integrate these renewable energy sources, which are volatile in nature, to the national grid, and take up its implementation much ahead of commissioning or the taking up the renewable generation projects. So that means the infrastructure is getting ready and the generator can simply hook up to the infrastructure and start flowing the power. So to address the short gestation period. To address the intermittency as well as uncertainty, we have established the Renewable Energy Management Center, which is having the forecasting of the renewable generation. That forecasted generation along with the weather forecasting, it is coming to the internal forecasting engine and giving a single output to the RE scheduling tool, and also taking the real-time tracking of the renewable generation. Those are combining and going to the SCADA and going to the conventional SCADA so that the operator can visualize or operator can estimate and schedule this non-dispatchable generation too. So we have already established 11 such renewable energy management center in the various state load dispatch center as well as regional load dispatch center, and those states are basically the renewable resource rich states in the country. To address the variability of this renewable generation, because of this variability, the maintaining the power system parameters in terms of the voltage, in terms of the system security as well as stability too, we have installed 18 numbers of large size dynamic compensator. It is a state of the art STATCOM, so that any variation in the power flow over the transmission network will not give a major impact to maintain the system security in terms of the voltage. So it is a shock absorber. So that have been installed. And this process is a continuous. Now, since the daytime, lot of renewables are coming and this conventional generation is backing down. So storage is there. One is the pump storage. Other types of storage are going on. And also, we have the policy of round-the-clock supply. Round-the-clock supply means that it can be bundling with the conventional generation. That renewable generation can be bundling with the conventional generation. Make it 80% available annually, and at least 51% of the energy has to come from the renewable sources. So here will also this energy storage will play a prominent role to maintain that round-the-clock supply. So that policy is in place. As far as the regulation part is concerned, we have the reserve regulation ancillary services. Already 48 generators of around 52 gigawatt is participating into this process, this reserve regulation ancillary services, so that we can maintain the primary response, we can maintain the frequency through this process. And also the another is frequency regulation ancillary services, so that is also in place as far as the regulation is concerned. Now as far as the energy storage is concerned, which type of energy storage, who will own the energy, so that is also defined. That if I have the renewable and it is a dispatchable, so that means I have to make a firmed power. So I may have to put the either the energy storage system or maybe bundling with the conventional, so that I can deliver that storage type of things. So we are basically working upon the pump storage hydro and also making a tariff in such a way so that during the off-peak period, the tariff is low and that time I can pump the energy, be it in the pump storage hydro or maybe in the other form of storage. And there will be a different tariff in the evening time or night time or peak time, then I can discharge it. So that will give a conducive framework for penetrating more and more energy storage. We have the Central Electricity Authority, which is the statutory body in our country. They have come out with a draft paper as far as the generation mix by 2030, where it is a total installed capacity is expected is around 830 plus gigs. And out of that, around 34 gigawatt will be the energy storage will be required. So that is a draft paper is already available in the website also. So in terms of the renewable penetration, in terms of the clean and affordable energy sources, we have the good plan as far as the energy storage is concerned. We have already the electricity power market is in place, regulation is in place, and also it is a continuous process. And we are also getting lessons learned from various utilities like European Union and others also, and trying to see that how it can be well fitted with the Indian context to make our grid safe, secure, stable, but also to ensure that consumer will get the clean power with a low cost energy round the clock. So that's the thing. So with these, I will stop my views here. Thank you so much.
Well.